first thing that comes to mind when you think of paneer? For me, obviously, it is paneer butter masala. And have you ever wondered how come it's so rich and creamy at restaurants? Well, that's exactly what we're going to make today, a very rich and creamy restaurant-style paneer butter masala. Let's get started. Take a kadai, pour 1 tablespoon of oil. To this, I'm going to add 2 large onions, roughly chopped. Saute the onions till they're transparent. Add about 10 red chillies. Add 3 large tomatoes, roughly chopped. 1/4 cup of cashew nuts. Next, I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of salt. Cook it till the tomatoes are nice and mushy. Turn off the stove. Cool the mixture. Transfer the cooled mixture into a mixer jar. Grind it in a mixer jar to a nice fine paste. To the same kadai, add 3 teaspoons of ghee. To this, add 2 teaspoons of Kashmiri red chili powder. Give it a quick mix. Keep the flame on medium. You don't want to get the chili powder to get burnt. Now add the ground tomato, onion and cashew paste. I've added a little water to the mixer jar to remove all the excess masala paste that's stuck to the jar. Next, I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of garam masala powder. I'm adding a few kasuri methi leaves, just crush them, and a handful of freshly chopped coriander leaves. Close and cook for about 10 minutes on low flame. To make the gravy much richer and creamier, I'm going to grind 50 grams of khoya, 3 tablespoons of milk, and grind it to a nice fine paste. You can also substitute this mixture of khoya and milk with condensed milk. If you don't have either of these, you can add a teaspoon of sugar to give you that light sweetness and to balance the flavors of the masala. I'm going to add 2 tablespoons of fresh cream. Add the ground khoya milk mixture. Since I've used unsweetened khoya, I'm going to add a teaspoon of sugar. You can skip adding sugar if your khoya is sweet. Mix everything together. Add 1/4 cup of water. Season it with 1 teaspoon of salt. I'm adding 300 grams of paneer cut into small cubes. Close and cook on low flame for about 10 minutes. So there you go, here is this delicious, rich and creamy paneer butter masala. It looks absolutely gorgeous and I can't wait to get a bite of that. So there you go, you can enjoy this rich and creamy paneer butter masala with some roti, naan or pulao. You can get a copy of our first edition of the Home Cooking book on Amazon and 21 Frames.